Good night, everyone. I'm Nadia Porter, and I'll be presenting on the pump servicing and maintenance section. So first thing we ask, why maintenance and servicing? Maintenance is an important factor in quality assurance and some cases determine the long-term success of a company. Poorly maintained resources can cause instability and partially or completely pause production. You know, sometimes I send someone to go take a look at the pump. The first thing I always ask them is, what is the pump not doing? What is the pump doing? What is the pressure of the pump? What is the discharge pressure of the pump? You know, I mean, is the pump running at all? Like, pumps are what we call cast and head devices. So therefore, as a cast and head device, this pump is gonna move fluid so fast, so high, and so far. And what's interesting about it is I can have a pump that generates a 100 feet of head. In pumping water at a 100 feet of head, the discharge pressure will be about, let's say, 43 psi. If I was pumping salt water is slightly more dense than water, so the pressure gauge would read around 57 psi. So those are stuff you really need to stop and think about, really. So let's take a look at maintenance classifications. Maintenance is usually split into two classifications, corrective and preventive maintenance. Corrective maintenance is essentially maintenance that is undertaken to cope with a pump failure that has already occurred, to avoid downtime caused by unexpected problems with the pump. It is also important to introduce preventive maintenance scheduling. So setting our sights onto pump monitoring, we would realize there are four areas that should be incorporated in pump maintenance programs. You would use visual inspections, vibration monitoring, bearing temperature, and pump performance monitoring and pump system analysis. So in determining the pump performance, ideally five parameters should be monitored to understand how a pump is performing: suction pressure, discharge pressure, flow, pump speed, and the power. So as we approach the end of the presentation, we will have a look at employing preventative maintenance, where we'll also look at some of what we can notice just by looking at a pump, say, hey, something is wrong, you know. So why should we do a maintenance program? A pump maintenance program would generally involve a periodic check of the pump performance and inspection of the wearing parts and lubrication of bearings and joints. It is good practice to carry out a visual inspection of the pump installation on a daily basis. Some of what we will notice by just taking a closer look at the pump will be, one of them would be like overheating. Basically, the pump motor or bearings getting really hot is not something that should be ignored, as it always indicates some form of problem, really. Having a look at leaks, you know, you should check the pump and the pipe work for any leaks that need to be dealt with, as this will result in reduced performance and loss of pump output, as well as mess. And you know, from mess in a workplace, you can have accident. We don't want accidents. A properly installed and well-working pump should not overly vibrate, and therefore any level of vibration deemed excessive should be investigated. Common causes includes the impeller being imbalance, damage and the misalignment of the pump and motor. Clogging. The presence of solids can result in the clogging of impellers or valves if the pump is not capable of handling the size of solids that have attempted to pass through. You will usually notice clogging quite quickly as the pump will not be able to deliver the same quantities of fluid. Unusual noise. One of the first signs of a problem with your pump is noise. Like anything with a motor, a consistent hum when the pump is running is quite normal. However, abnormally loud noises or a clunking or crunching sound is likely to indicate an issue. Worn bearings could be an example. A popping sound, particularly if it's near the impeller, could mean the pump is experiencing cavitation, which can cause a lot of damage. Finally, we have a look at corrosion. Rusting, cracking, or discoloration of the pump casing or pipework need to be acted on immediately, as there are all signs of corrosion. Corrosion can not only result in pump failure through a weakening of the casing and components, but also contamination of the fluid being pumped. Finally, we take a look at servicing overall. It can be summarized in just a few points, really. So, consult the original manufacturer's guidelines. Consider the timing to schedule your maintenance. Get to know your system and make a point to observe your pump while it is running. Make sure machines are properly shut down before performing your maintenance and or systems check. Proper isolation is important, not only for electrical systems but for hydraulic systems as well. It will then be safe to start the mechanical inspection where lubrication or electrical/motor inspection takes place.